The Braddock Bay Observatory on Lake Ontario isn't just a great spot to watch birds. There's actually some scientific work going on here. David Bonter is with Cornell University, and David, you with your volunteers here are involved in quite a project. What happens inside here?
That's right. We band about 8,000 birds a year during both spring and fall migration, about 100 different species of birds, including a lot of warblers like this northern water thrush here. And each bird will leave here wearing a individually numbered aluminum leg band and different size bands for different size birds. And we'll put the band on and take a number of measurements.
The birds are caught in nylon mesh nets, which are nearly invisible. Volunteers check the nets every half hour and bring whatever birds they collect back to the station for banding and measuring.
Now, the fact that you've tagged it, is this a universal project, or are you counting on this bird to return here?
No.
Or are there other scientists as far away as who knows where that might be cooperating in this same venture?
There are actually millions of birds banded in North America each year. It's all coordinated by the Federal Bird Banding Lab at Patuxent in Washington, D.C. And so they provide us with the bands. We do everything else. We send all the data back there. So if we catch a bird here that's already banded that we didn't band ourselves, we send that information to Washington, and they let us know where the bird was originally encountered. One gray catbird was actually found on an oil rig in the Gulf of Mexico not too long after we banded it here. So a number of birds turn up in interesting places.
From bright red cardinals to young cedar waxwings, the Braddock Bay Birding Pit Stop is an extraordinary spot for ornithological research.
Bird in the hand is worth...
He's about to go get him out the door.
It's a beautiful bird. We hate to see it go. But be free.
Don't hit the car.
That was great.